has certain beliefs and I have my own belief and we can agree to disagree on certain things. But this is what makes sports so amazing, that we can start a discussion around a table in the newspaper and the magazines that will get people's attention. And that's what sports does. Newton, of course, created headlines before Super Bowl 50 when he described himself as an African-American quarterback that may scare a lot of people because they haven't seen nothing they can compare me to. He later backed off those comments, saying that the game was bigger than those labels. Stephen A., what do you make of Cam's latest comments?
Well, I applaud them. I'm happy that Cam Newton made these comments. I agree with him. Everything is not about race. And I think that we live in a society where it's two different kind of things going on. there are times when things are racial, but not racism or racist. People come from different cultures, different backgrounds, different ethnic backgrounds, different environments, etc. And as a result of that, they have different experiences. And when they express it, how it's absorbed more often than not tends to define how it's defined and how it's perceived and absorbed by the masses. And I think that leads to polarizing our society more and more every day. I think when people listen to folks, particularly folks from the black community, explain things, you will find that a lot more often than not, folks are not calling anybody racist. What they're saying is that from a racial perspective, you may view it differently than we do. Now, that's twofold. On one hand, your white folks, you have to understand that from an historical perspective, you're going to affect people in a certain way because history affects people in a certain way, and they have a right to be affected by it. On the other hand, if you're the black community, we've got to guard ourselves against getting so emotional over everything that we find ourselves in a putting others in a position where they don't even want to express themselves. Therefore, nobody is honest, nobody is forthcoming, and we continue to be divided. Cam Newton hit the target in the middle here. He's a guy that came into the league looking up to Warren Moon, first black quarterback in the Hall of Fame. And Warren Moon, he asked Warren Moon one time. I remember reading an article recently by Jeff Jadeer, who used to work, he's now at the NFL Network, a great, great reporter. He interviewed Cam Newton, and Cam Newton told him about he had asked Warren Moon a question about what's the one thing that he regret. And he regretted. And Warren Moon said that I didn't enjoy the game more. Well, back when Warren Moon was playing, assimilation was the order of the day. You were a quarterback. You had to conduct yourself in a certain way in order to be embraced and thereby accepted by mainstream, therefore put in a position where you were allowed to elevate and let your talents shine and speak for you. You know, but you were relatively mild-mannered in a public eye. A Warren Moon, a Doug Williams, a Randall Cunningham, the list goes on and on. In the case of Cam Newton, just like Jeff Jadeer wrote in his article, we're talking about evolution. We're talking about a Cam Newton a la a Magic Johnson, somebody who's vibrant and bullion and had a great personality and had a magic smile and, you know, was just magnetic and you gravitated to him. But along the way, the difference between a Magic Johnson and a Cam Newton is that Magic Johnson played in a league that was where a vast majority of the athletes are black, meaning around 80%. It's still a majority black in the NFL, but it's in the 60s as opposed to the 80 percentile. And what you have is a situation where even though Magic Johnson was the leader and he was a superstar, he was Showtime, he had that smile, and he had a white adversary to go up against, which was that of Larry Bird. So it sort of offset itself. And you didn't mind Showtime against the blue collar and, you know, all of this other stuff. Yep. Cam essentially is in a league by himself as it pertains to his behavior because of the impact that he has. That smile, coupled with his level of production, coupled with the dabbing, coupled with the doing, you know, giving footballs to kids and all of this other stuff, he's also a guy that's judged significantly more than the average dude playing in his position because the average dude playing his position don't conduct themselves that way. So he's held to a higher standard. I applaud Cam Newton for seeming to have a sense of that reality and recognizing that at times he's not as much a victim of race per se as he is a victim of quote unquote assimilation, how you're supposed to act playing a certain position, how you're supposed to act being an NFL quarterback, how you're supposed to act because Tom Brady acted this way and Peyton Manning acted this way and even the Warren Moon and the Randall Cunninghams and the Doug Williams acted this way and the Russell Wilson today acts this way. You're not supposed to be any different. His sense that those things may play a role in judging and defining him, and him having the intellect and the poise to express himself in that way instead of leaning on the easy explanation of race as the cause for any vitriol coming in his direction, I think Cam Newton should be applauded for that, because the race card is something that needs to be employed when necessary. That is not always. That is not most of the time. Sometimes it is, but sometimes it's not. And as a black community, we have to recognize that.
The distinction between racist and racial is important, of course, because race has been the defining issue of American life. I mean, it's been this way for centuries now, and it remains so, even though there's this urge to live in a post-racial world. The OJ documentary that we did was, you know, here on ESPN was partly about that. OJ wanted to live in a post-racial world, and he just couldn't. And, you know, it wasn't the reality.
OJ's a bad example because he was a complete sellout. He didn't like his own. He didn't want to be associated with his own. Right. That is entirely different.
Let's table OJ in that case, because I don't want to get sidetracked. So Cam makes the distinction between racial and racist, I think. That's what you take from this. And listen, even in this election cycle, racial identity politics are playing an enormous role here. And so we live in that kind of, in that world still here in the United States. And the idea that you can separate race from these issues, I don't think is possible. I think partly the reaction to Cam is viewed through a racial prism, and that colors, so to speak, for many, the way he's perceived. Now, that doesn't mean that, listen, of course there are some racist idiots who see him not jump on the ball in the Super Bowl and go, I'll see a white man would have jumped on that. But I'm not talking about them. There are always outliers and fanatics and morons. I'm talking about the general reaction of normal people to Cam. It can still be colored, again, so to speak, by racial identity without people even being aware of it. Because when you look at Cam's overall behavior, dabbing when he scores, so what? Handing balls to children doesn't seem to get nearly as much press. The fact that he was the best player in the world last year, you know, there's constant kind of negative talk around it in a way that there wasn't when, let's say, Brett Favre was the best player in the world, or Aaron Rodgers, or Tom Brady, even until he was scandalized, you know, through the Patriots, through Deflategate and Spygate and all that kind of stuff. So I think you can't separate race from it. But if his claim is basically that that's not the prime mover here, that's not the main catalyst of people's negative reactions, I think that's fair to say. It may not be the prime mover, but I do think it's involved somehow, because there's too much vitriol against
it. It may be involved, but understand that he doesn't want to focus on it, number one, because that's not something tangible that you can point to and prove. It may be there, but certain times it's more provable than others. But when you look at it from that perspective, you also got to gauge when to sit up there and bring something like that up. Michael Jordan deciding to make a donation, you know, to address Black Lives Matter, police brutality and the like, and violence against police officers, all of that stuff. It was so profound because Michael Jordan doesn't customarily say something or do something that brings attention to a particular cause in that regard that we know of. So when he felt the need to do so, it matters. If Cam Newton takes this position and he says something like that, right? But then he speaks out against something, it's going to resonate significantly. Whereas if he was so quick to point out race about every little thing that Cam Newton's way,
the so-called, then, you know, the more the so-called, as you put it, race card is played, the less credible it seems when you play it. So he, in a sense, is building equity with football fans, at least, so that if and when he decides to address the issue, it carries more weight. I think that's legitimate.
I don't think it's solely race, but I think it's a part of it. I think it's four-pronged. I think it's the race issue with him in terms of criticism. I think it's the position he plays, how quarterbacks are supposed to act and be the leader of the team and not speak. He's that new era, the younger generation that's having social media and things like that we don't see of the other quarterbacks. And then also being a victim of his success. As talented as Cam since the Tom Brady, Aaron Rodgers.
He seems to be criticized more than others who've been in his position in the recent past.
Let's also remember not to ignore proximity. I love North Carolina. Mm-hmm. I went to Winston-Salem State. I'm a proud graduate of Winston-Salem State University, which is just an hour away. He presides in the Bible Belt.
Yes.
It matters. It matters. Mm-hmm.
I think it's a good point.
Demographic, another point there as well. When we come back, we're going to switch gears. Conor McGregor ready and willing to take on Floyd Mayweather. Matt.